Hey everyone, Ken Pearson here. This video is about Greater Than Gatsby overlays. Now, if you're new to photography, you're probably asking yourself, what's an overlay? Well, to best explain it, you've probably seen several photographs where you have families or children in a field someplace at sunset, and you're getting this beautiful warm sunlight coming through, and it looks like they have a sunburst off to their side or just behind them, and it's really accentuating the picture, and you're wondering, wow, how did the photographer catch that? Well, true, that can be achieved within the camera in the right environment at the right time with the right positions. And a lot of the photographers that are out there do have the capability of doing that. However, it's a lot easier just to shoot out there in the field and then apply all this in post. So along with all the Photoshop actions and Lightroom presets that Greater Than Gatsby offers, they also have some fantastic overlays, which I'm going to show you how easy it is to apply to any photo. Rather than do the typical family photos, though, of course, I want to use another kind of photograph to show that they can be used in a variety of different environments. So let's take a look at how this works. Again, this is a quick tutorial on how simple, easy, Greater Than Gatsby makes your life as a photographer. So let's get started. All right, so this is the image that we're going to use, and this is straight out of the camera. This was shot in a parking garage, and if you're not familiar with the characters, they're from Star Wars. This is going to be Boba Fett off to the right, and this is going to be Princess Leia dressed up as a bounty hunter when she visited Jabba the Hutt's lair. So this is actually taking place, this scene, if it were actually in the movie, is taking place in an underground sort of cave that's very musty, very sandy. There's just nothing but dirt and filth in the air, and it's very brown, very, very sepia tonish to this. So I knew that was the direction I was going to be going with in the end, but one of the things that I thought would be relevant to this is that you can see in some of the actual film footage, there seems to be this light coming through, and we do have one stronger light source over here, that flash that fired on this side, and basically that's where I'm going to use my overlay to come through. And I'm going to make this as subtle as I possibly can, but you'll see that it's not only going to provide, as you're used to seeing with overlays, it's not only going to provide that warmth that's coming through, but it's also going to give you the haziness that's important to this scene as well, okay? So this is very, very straightforward. This is not a long tutorial. Basically, what I'm going to do is this. I showed you the out of the camera. I did my final touches and my final edits, and this is the look that I want to go with, okay? So I'm not going to cover in all the details that I went here, but I am going to go ahead and I'm going to apply the actual overlay in this case. So again, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to File, and then I'm going to go to Place. And it's going to take me to my hard drive, and I'm going to go over here, this is the different overlays that Greater Than Gatsby has offered me. I'm going to choose this particular one over here. Okay, all right, so it's going to give me this nice lens flare. I'm going to click Place, and it's going to resize it to the size of the actual image. Okay, it's placing it over it. Now you can still see that it's showing up a little bit here. What I'm going to do is that I'm not going to worry about the size right now. I'm just going to hit Enter, and it's going to place this on top. Now, for the sake of being practical for later on in this exercise, what I am going to do is I'm going to make a group, and I'm just going to take these two layers here, okay, and put them in this group. All right, then I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. Now, the one thing I want to do here is that now you see this lens flare is coming through, and it covers most of the image here. And what I'm going to do is that I'm going to focus on this, and all I want to do is change it from normal to screen. And by doing that, what it's going to do is it's going to make all the black areas transparent. Okay? Now, this isn't the position I want the lens flare to be in, so now I can adjust it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do Command-T or Control-T, and basically it's going to give me my flexibility back where I can place this any way I want, I can shape it any way I want. Okay? So I'm just going to keep it in its sort of original context. And I'm going to place it off to the side over here. Okay? I want it out of the way, like this. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to stretch it down so it covers most of where Leia is, okay? All the way past maybe here like this, okay? Now, I know it sounds really strong, but we're just going to change the opacity of a layer in a moment, okay? So I'm going to do this. Perfect. Now, what I do want to get rid of is this little line here, so it's old-fashioned eraser tool, okay? What I'll do here is I have to rasterize this. All right, now my eraser comes to life. I've put a lower opacity here, and I'm just gonna start working on this, okay? I can get a little bit more courageous and do some more, you know. I'll do this here like this. Maybe I'll just bring it up a little bit, closer to 50. Just really blend that in like this. It doesn't make a difference, it's black, so it's you can hardly see what I'm doing here. It's just getting rid of that hard line. All right, so that's good. And this thing I want to do here is I want to bring this down quite a bit, okay? Just want to give this some sort of sense that when you look at this, I'm really focusing here on her, okay? I want to get that sort of flare coming through. Then it makes him a little bit more mysterious in the background, right? I'm getting this hazy look for him. What I may want to do is here is just push this out of, and I don't worry about this too much, okay? So you can see here, I probably need some more erasing going on just to make sure that nothing escapes me in this. Okay, I'm gonna do that here like this. All right, I can bring that down maybe just a little bit more, we'll try, okay? You can play with this, doesn't make a difference. That's the whole point about these, is that you're obviously going to be working with the opacity of how bright you want the lens flare to be, and of course you have your eraser tool to get rid of some of these things like I'm talking about, okay? So she's the forefront here, she's the figure that we're looking at, he's just an accessory in the background, but he's also important to the scene, okay? Especially if you know the film. So now that I have this, let's just assume that, you know, I've got this here. The next thing I want to do to fix all of this is I want to crop this down. Okay, so I'm just gonna, I want to get a little bit tighter in here, okay? Really tight. And I'll show you how I'm gonna place this. I'm just gonna do this. Okay, so they're both there. Gonna really put something tight in there like that. Okay? Let's see what that looks like. I like it. Okay? So that's what you're working with. Now you can see that the lens flare is present, but it's not as predominant as it was because it's really out of the scene. But it's really giving some nice contrast to what's coming through here. This lens, you know, we can bring it down just a little bit more if we want. We can do whatever we would like with it. Just make it as subdued as we need to. But I kind of like the dusty atmosphere that it provides the higher that we make it. See, when we bring this in here, it's a little bit just showing, it's bringing in some tint and some light rays, which you hardly see here. But if you bring this up, it gives it a new feeling, this new natural feeling of this dustiness that's in this layer. And as a matter of fact, you know, when you look at this, no longer looks like a garage wall anymore, does it? I mean, it actually looks like it's inside a cave, inside that scene in the movie. So that's how you can apply lens flares, not just in some of the more common areas you see them, like I said, the family photos and whatnot out in the fields, but bring them into some other areas, into some indoor shots. They can actually be great for simulating light or even accenting light. In this case, you're not just bringing in that light, but you're bringing in that dusty, hazy look that you can really apply to some of your photographs. So again, that's Greater Than Gatsby. I put the link down below where you can go ahead and you can download their Photoshop actions and their presets, their Lightroom presets, and they come with a couple of overlays like the ones that I've showed you, and this one specifically, and then a couple more. They also have clouds that you can include too as well, so there's quite a bit that they offer. There's a huge, tremendous amount of value in these actions and these presets from Greater Than Gatsby. If you're new to photography or a seasoned shooter, I definitely recommend getting involved with those Photoshop actions, because you can see here, you don't have to be a whiz at Photoshop to do these things. It's very Photoshop 101, and that's what I love about these. Thanks for watching. Take care.